the underbody of the car scraping. That's okay though. Here's the Kia on the same grade as what the Hyundai was on a minute ago. And even it's got some wheel slip. The tyres are really preventing it from going where it wants to go. There's obviously no traction control. As you can see, having low range makes an enormous amount of difference. There's no wheel slip at all. G'day and welcome to today's edition of My RV TV. Today we've got two vehicles that have all-wheel drive and four-wheel drive capabilities. The Kia Sorento Diesel EXL Limited and the Hyundai Santa Fe Elite. Two vehicles in that $45,000 to $50,000 price bracket, four-cylinder diesels aimed at that family market. I guess the key here is, are they worthwhile looking at compared to a Prado or a Pajero, to see whether, for the most part, these vehicles would suit what the normal family would want in terms of everyday driving and some off-road capabilities. They're probably not the type of vehicles that you'd want to do a lot of serious four-wheel driving in, but for the most part, these are the vehicles will suit most people most of the time. So let's have a look and see how they go. We'll start with the Kia. Okay, the Kia obviously has a bit more ground clearance. We're not hearing as much scraping as we're going down. As you can see, the Kia has a bit of scraping, but it's better ground clearance and it's four-wheel drive and better wheel articulation is making this a much easier prospect. Okay, you can see that that's a reasonable sort of step up and the Kia's done it pretty well. Here's the Kia on the same grade as what the Hyundai was on a minute ago. And even it's got some wheel slip to a slightly different line. But does it easily in the end. Okay, this is a slightly harder grade yet again. But again, slight wheel travel, slight wheel slip, and away it goes.
Probably about the only thing I would say about this car and the Hyundai is the fact that the front seat travel is a little bit limited. I do find myself just a little bit crowded. But what that does do, it gives plenty of room in the back for the rear passengers. Comfortable for two adults and one child, three adults at a pinch. Nice thick rim steering wheel, only height adjustable, not reach adjustable. Has the cruise control sitting on the steering wheel, which is a very easy facility to use. Look, it's not bad, it's quite comfortable. Nice sunroof, kids love that. Okay, we're sitting in the Santa Fe now. This is a more modern interior. It's not to say there's anything wrong with the Kia, but this is definitely a more modern interior with a foot brake. It has height and reach adjustable steering wheel, which is good. It has also the radio controls on the steering wheel as well as the cruise control. It has electric seat for the driver with multiple adjustments. It has better sound deadening than the Kia. And I'd say the motor is probably a little bit quieter. The Kia has a more powerful motor and they both drive beautifully on the road. And as you can see, on this dirt road we're driving on, there's very little internal vibration. So that's quite a good feature for both of them. The seven seats in the Hyundai are good for two teenage children I've put in there. I actually put in three teenage children the other day. They, at a pinch, you can drive for a short period of time. You wouldn't want to be driving to Newcastle in them, but they're okay. Look, the inside of this Hyundai is quite a pleasant place to be. They've obviously targeted this at the Lexus. Its fit and finish is first rate. I'm not so keen on the fake wood interior, but again, like the Kia, it has limited seat travel. So I'm a little bit cramped in the front. The payoff for that is that the rear passengers have more than adequate enough room for their knees and legs.
As you can hear, the Hyundai's that ground clearance again, it's scraping in places where the Kia didn't. It's spinning its wheels occasionally. It's coming through okay there. And again, bit of wheel slip, bit of scrape, but in the end it came through okay. The tyres that are really preventing it from going where it wants to go, there's obviously no traction control. Okay, we're going to try the steeper grade now in the Hyundai. Finish and see how it goes. Trying to pick the same line. Okay, we had to build that up slightly because the front plastic spoiler was scraping. And that's just the underbody of the car scraping. It's okay though. And no traction control. As you can see now, we get one wheel spinning and that's it. We're gone. Well, there we have it. The Hyundai Santa Fe Elite and the Kia Sorento EXL Limited. Slightly different versions of the same end result. The Hyundai, I guess you'd say, is probably more aimed towards the on-road, whereas the Kia has the same on-road characteristics, but a little bit more aimed towards the off-road, the four-wheel drive. The Kia has a little bit better ground clearance. It has the low range, which makes a difference, as you just saw from where we were going. The Hyundai, on the other hand, probably performs a little bit better on road, is a little bit quieter inside, and is aimed a bit more at the family market, having seven seats, which the Kia doesn't have. So there we have two vehicles aiming at the same market. 44,000 odd for the Kia, 48,990 for the Hyundai. Slightly more expensive. You do get a few more features in the Hyundai. You get the seven seats, you get rear air conditioning down the back in the sills, you get the electronic driver's seat with multiple adjustment, and there's some more features inside. Both are five-speed automatic Tiptronics. Both are 2-litre diesel motors. The Kia is a little bit more powerful than the Hyundai. The Hyundai has a sleeker design. It's probably because it's a newer design and they've really aimed it towards, I would say, the Lexus. Whereas the Kia is a bit of an older design, probably due for an update soon, but it still has an aggressive sort of look that if you're looking for something in the all-wheel drive, four-wheel drive market, that you'd probably be happy with. Both suit families of five perfectly. Both are capable in terms of dirt tracks and sandy beaches. And for 95% of the population, both would suit perfectly what they want to do, and that is the normal run around every day, picking the kids up, dropping the shopping off, and the occasional beach foray or dirt road. Where we took them today is probably a little bit more aggressive four-wheel driving than they would really go to, but it's not terrible. There are some tricky bits here, but it's good for testing out the vehicles. What we did find is the Kia had, with its low range, better off-road capabilities. It had better wheel travel, better ground clearance, and wasn't spinning its wheels anywhere near as much as what the Hyundai has. So there we have it. Two vehicles aimed at the same market. One aimed more at on-road, one has more off-road capabilities. Both good vehicles. There really isn't a winner. If you bought one, either one, you'd be happy with them. So I think they're probably vehicles that the market tends to overlook. And they shouldn't, because these are very capable, very comfortable, and quite luxurious vehicles for economical prices. Have a look at these as compared to some of the bigger four-wheel drives, as in the Pajero and the Prados, because again, for what most people use them for, these would be more than adequate. Well, that's it from Any Auto TV. We'll see you next time.